We're now going to talk about the actual fragment shader that is used to implement the OpenGL shading computations. This corresponds to the fragment shader for MyTest 3, which is the program you compiled for homework 0. This needs to be adapted and generalized in order for you to do homework 2. Here is the setup. In the fragment shader, we've already talked about the vertex shader, which simply passes in the color, the normal, and the vertex. So here is the inputs. It's taking in color, normal, and vertex. And again, this variable will depend on your specific system and take it from the skeleton code, whether it's attribute or something else. Here I'm defining a sampler 2D, which is for texture. The keyword uniform means that it doesn't change over the different fragments. So it really remains the same over the whole image. IsText is just an integer 0 or 1 saying, do I texture or not? IsLight is again, are we lighting or not? So this is the basic global variables. Let's talk about the shader variables. And here we are assuming that light 0 is directional, light 1 is a point light. Of course, your program needs to handle more general cases in homework 2. And the actual light values are passed from the main OpenGL program. So you have light 0 direction, because light 0 is a directional light, so it's vec 3. And again, note that these are characteristics of the GLSL shading language. I'm showing you actual GLSL code. So this is a uniform, again, because it's the same across all the fragments, vec 3, light 0 direction. Light color is a 4-vector RGBA. Light 4, 1 position is a 4-vector because it's a positional light, so in homogeneous coordinates. Light 1 color is again the color. Now set the material parameters. These could be varying on a per vertex, per fragment basis, but we won't get into that here. We'll just make them uniform. So ambient, diffuse, specular, and these are vec4s again because they're colors. And shininess is just a floating point value. It's a single number. Here is my program to compute the lighting. So it takes in a large number of arguments. So const in vec3 direction. It means it's a constant, just as in standard C++, it's the direction, the light color, the normal, the halfway vector, the diffuse component, the specular component, and the shininess. Okay? And in fact, this, I mean, some version of this you will be using in homework too, so do look at it carefully. I compute the dot product of the normal and the lighting, which is dot product of normal and direction. Of course, I haven't told you how to specify the direction, etc. yet, and that will be coming later. I say the Lambertian is equal to the diffuse component times the light color times the n dot l 0. So the diffuse component, n dot l, and then using the light color. Half angle is n dot h is dot product of the normal and the half vector. And the Phong is my specular times light color times power of n dot h to my shininess. And what I return is Lambert plus Phong. So here are the main transformations in the fragment shader. So if isText is greater than 0, then the fragment color is the result of texturing. So in that case, we ignore the lighting. You could, of course, store this value and modulate the lighting computation as well. If his light is 0, then again you return. So we are interested in what happens at the cells. Note that the I in OpenGL is always at the origin looking down the minus z axis. So that's a standard convention. Therefore, we set the I pause to the origin. And then my pause is model view matrix times my vertex. So this gives me the vertex location in I coordinates. So I'm applying the model view matrix to the vertex. And then I'm dehomogenizing it here. So I'm going through the whole pipeline of getting my coordinates and I coordinates and dehomogenizing it. So I actually have a 3D location. Then I find the direction to the I, which is simply the I direction minus my pause. So the vector from my location to the I, normalized. Now I come to normal. And again, I put in comments that you can actually do this GL normal matrix, but I want to show you something a bit more complicated. Remember that the normal transform is you take the model view matrix and you take the inverse transpose. So the normal matrix is always the inverse transpose. And that's nicely specified to you here in the normal matrix, but I want to do a little bit more. So I say model view inverse transpose okay, times this quantity. Vec4 is just creating a 4 vector, so it takes the normal and it adds a w coordinate of 0. And after I've done that, I take only the xyz values. So I'm really interested only in the xyz values, or really the multiplication of the upper 3 by 3. And the reason I need to do that is the inverse transpose. Of course, inverse transpose is the whole 4 by 4, but I'm only interested in the upper 3 by 3 and the xyz coordinates for the normal. And normal matrix does that part automatically. And then finally, I just renormalize the normal. So coming back to the fragment shader, how do we handle the directional light and the point light? So the directional light, you normalize the light direction, the half vector, you add up the direction, the I direction, and you take normalize it, and then you compute the light. For the point light, you dehomogenize the location of the light, and then you again compute the direction for the light. Again, notice that there's no attenuation. Compute the half vector and you call the color. So study this code carefully. Your homework 2 code will very likely be based on it, but is slightly more general. So just again to recap the outline here, we've talked about Guru and Fong shading. We've talked about the types of lighting, the ambient, diffuse, emissive, specular. We've talked about the fragment shader. And the final thing we need to talk about is what is the source code in the main OpenGL program in the display routine. Okay, and here, so we have a bunch of things to set up the lighting. So here is just definitions, right? So this is one defining a lot of things. This was the shininess, which we just tried changing. And I've just defined light specular, direction, position. So one of the things I do is to transform the lights by the model view matrix. So lights are just like geometry, and they have to transform by the model view matrix. But this is difficult to do inside the shader because the lights are transformed by the model view matrix at the time you hit the light command, whereas within the shader, the model view matrix could be different for different vertices and fragments. So I'm doing these transformations manually. And transform vec is just a 4x4 matrix multiplier. So again, I'm just reminding you here that light transforms like other geometry, only the model view matrix, because you're not projecting lights down, they operate in 3D space. And you can have various different interesting things you can do to the types, to the light. So you can set the transforms to identity before specifying the light, so it's stationary. You can move the light in the standard way, push the matrix, position the light, move the light, pop the matrix. You can move the light source with the viewpoint, which is like light attached to a miner's hat. And it's very useful because it ensures that every object you see actually has light falling on it, so you don't get a black screen anywhere. So you can simply set the light to 000 because that's where the OpenGL origin is, and make the model view matrix the identity before doing this. So here is my transform vector, and essentially it's just a matrix multiplier taking into account the fact that OpenGL stores matrices in column major operation. And you can in fact do this more simply with a simple matrix multiplier in GLM if you handle the conventions properly. Okay, so now we've come to setting up the lighting for the teapot. And here we see this command, GL uniform 3FV. So that means you set a uniform variable in the fragment shader or the vertex shader. 3FV means 3 floatings and V. So essentially what you're doing is you're saying light zero direction, you're setting it, there's a vector of 1 element because it's just a single value, and you're setting it to light zero. So light zero color again, and again 4FV, so is it a 3 vector direction, is a 4 vector. So 4FV, light position, 1 position, light 1 color. And then you set the ambient, you set the diffuse, you set the specular, you set the shininess. And now, I set this demo command so that I can flip through by increasing the demo and show you various examples. We'll do that the next lecture. But essentially, again, uniform 1i means it's a single integer. And I set it to 1 or 0 depending on this lighting value. And I will enable and disable lighting around the teapot to ensure that only the teapot gets the shader. Okay, so in the initialization also I need to write some code. So I do the standard initialize shaders for the vertex and fragment shaders, set up the shader program. And then these are a sequence of things which set up the parameter mapping. So I want to know where this isLight command in the shader, the isLight variable, what variable number should it be attached to? And so this is the idiom that gets you that. You say gl get uniform location in the shader program isLight, and I'm just setting it to the same variable so that I can use these variables later. In summary, in this lecture, we've talked about lighting and shading. And in this final segment, I've shown you the basics of a fragment shader and fragment program. Of course, if you want to get more familiar with GLSL, there are many materials and tutorials available online, and I would recommend that you look over them. However, the code we provided is self-contained in itself and gives you the basic syntax of OpenGL and GLSL, and simply by generalizing and modifying the shader code that we provided with MyTest3, it should be possible to write the appropriate shaders for homework 2.